Story time, story time, story time. Yeah. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to do a little story time to share with you something different that I have yet to share. You guys know that I've been sharing little snippets of our story, of our lives thus far, of our, you know, about our family. And so this is just natural to share a little bit more, you know what I'm saying? So anyways, today's story is going to be talking a little bit about something that I haven't told you yet, and it is a tummy tuck. Guys, after having my third child, baby Shar, I had a tummy tuck 2 years after having her. The reason for that being is that during my pregnancy, I explained to you guys, if you guys have checked out any of my pregnancy video, you would have noticed that I said that I gained 100 pounds with the first pregnancy, 85 with the second, and 75 with the third. That is a lot of weight. And with that, my stomach expanded. I have to say, the first pregnancy, I went completely overboard. I really did. So that took a toll on me. And so after my third pregnancy, my muscle, that core muscle that separates while your stomach is growing, well, for me, it never closed back. And people will say, oh, it goes back together and it should go back to normal and whatnot. However, after having my last child, it was 2 years, maybe 2.5 years after, it still wasn't closed, and it became an inconvenience because I could literally push my hand in there. And you might say, why would you ever do that? And I'm just telling you that I could. And whenever I worked out, because I had to work my butt off to just get back into shape, I'm even bigger now than I was after my third child. It makes no sense, I know, but I'm getting my life together. However, whenever I worked out, and especially doing crunches and sit-ups, the contents of my stomach would kind of bulge through, and it was becoming like, it was not very comfortable, and it was not very good. It was so gross, and Aaron could vouch for that to let you know what it felt like sticking his hand kind of like in my stomach, into my stomach. It was just gross. Anyways, so with that being said, the only thing that one can do to solve that is to have a tummy tuck. You could live with it, or you can have a tummy tuck, and I chose to have a tummy tuck. It wasn't my first surgery. I've had 3 C-sections, and I've also had a breast reduction. So with that, I don't know, it wasn't that uncommon for me to decide to have that procedure done. So I did it. So there goes, I've already answered 2 questions for you, I think. So the first one was why I got it done, and I just explained my reason. And the second one was, when did you get it done? And I just explained that it was about 2.5 years after I had my first child. The third part is my experience. How was it? I met with a doctor about 3 to 4 months prior to the surgery, maybe even longer. So I was very prepared. I researched a lot. I knew what I was getting into. I also knew the issues that could go wrong. Gosh, yeah, that was a little nerve-wracking. However, I went ahead and had the surgery. So I had to drive out of town to my surgeon because I did live about 1 or 2 away. So I stayed the night overnight in the city, and then went into surgery early in the morning. Thank God, because I had my first C-section. That was an emergency C-section where my doctor must have been asleep or something, because my scar from my C-section looked like jagged edge. Like, why did it look like that? I was so disappointed. Thank God. My other 2 surgeries were actually planned early in the morning, and with that said, my C-section scars are darn near invisible. It just goes to show you what a well-rested doctor can do. So if you guys are ever planning on doing surgery, please request that your doctor is well-rested. Like, early surgeries are probably best. Anyway, so I did go in. I had my surgery at about 8 o'clock in the morning. You go in and you get all prepped and whatnot, and then that's all I remember. Blacked out whenever he put that mask on me, and I was inhaling all that drugs that I took. I don't even know what it is, but that's all I remember going into the surgery. And then after coming out, I was loopy as heck. Like, I just remember being very, very out of it. I remember the drive home, I was just like dozing in and dozing out and trying to talk to Aaron. Like, I was just so out of it. So, upon reaching home, that night I probably just went to bed. I was just like, you know, it's just that stage, like, oh my gosh, you really did it. Here you are. Now it's just a recovery time. I went home walking like a grandma, like a hunchback. It was just like, you're walking all hunched over because, you know, your stomach is now tightened. And you go home with a compression garment on, which is used to compress the fluids out of your stomach. And you also go home with two tubes in your like peri area. That sounds weird. Okay, so say for instance, this is the V line for your bikini line. Now this is the V for your yuha, your private part. You get one drain tucked in over here and one drain tucked in over here, and they are just hanging out of your body. And being collected in a drain package, which you have to drain yourself and clean. And it's there in there for about 3 weeks, if not longer. It all depends on how well you're draining. So that was kind of embarrassing because I had a life to live. And after my surgery, like, I think hubby was home with me for about 2 weeks. But then, you know, even going out on the street or going on the road, whatever it is, I ended up having to travel with this drainage in me. So I had to, luckily I had like sweaters and stuff. I wore baggy sweaters. It was like around winter time, so it didn't look so bad. And I was able to camouflage them in it wherever I went, you know, so and whatnot. Outside of that, I ended up getting the drains taken out. I think I went to an appointment a week after my surgery and things seemed fine. And then, you know, I went back another 2 weeks and maybe that's when I got the drains taken out, I think. Recovery process seemed to have been doing fine, but I did notice that I still had some swelling. And unfortunately, 6 to 8 months after, I actually had to go back into surgery because my stomach was still retaining a lot of water. And I had to go back into surgery a second time for him to do whatever the heck he did. I don't know what he did, but he did it. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. Like, overall, the experience was all right. It was pretty good. But I feel like my experience could have been a lot better had I gone with a more, I don't know, my doctor was professional and he was well known, but he wasn't one of the most expensive. He was like in between. I feel like if I paid a little bit more on the higher end, I could have got maybe a little bit more for my money. I wasn't 100% pleased with it, with what he did per se. I don't know what to say if I was 100% pleased. I think the part that I'm not pleased about is just the fact that when I went in the second time for him to revise the surgery or whatever, he moved my belly button down, like he just like pulled my skin down, which brought my belly button down a little bit lower than I would have liked. But aside from that, everything is fine. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't know what else to say. Would I recommend this surgery? I definitely would recommend the surgery, especially if you had something similar to what I was dealing with. It's just not very fun to deal with. Imagine you go to do a crunch and your muscle here goes like this and the contents of your stomach just like sticks through. It's disgusting. It feels gross and I'm just glad that I dealt with it. Like, you have to just take into account the very things that can go with surgery, the things that can go wrong, and also the reason why you're doing it. So maybe, you know, I felt fine for the reason I was doing it because the main reason is sealed. I have to say, when you do go to work out, even after, it's very weird and awkward and uncomfortable, and you'll feel that you'll get swelling from time to time. I'm at the point now where it's not an issue too much anymore, but every now and again, I'll still notice it. And this is years and years later, like 5 years later. So I definitely would recommend it for whatever your reason is, but most definitely for the reason why I went for it, because I think it can, it definitely solves that problem. I have to say, I mean, I did get that other perk that came with it because it tightened things up a bit, because when that muscle is sealed or when it's left open, it really isn't holding you back the way it should. Therefore, you have like it makes your posture look kind of poor in a sense. It wasn't anything that was like, oh my gosh, she looks like, or you know, anything like highly visible, but I know my body, I know when things are off, and I know what it feels like. So anyways, yeah, I want to share that with you, and let me know if any of you yourselves have ever gone through this surgery, if you're considering it, and if you, I have a ton of pictures. My pictures, they look really bad because I just felt. So I thought about including some, but I just don't know. So anyways, just let me know if you've ever dealt with any of what I've dealt with, and if you have any questions further that you would like me to answer, I can do that. I can answer them as well. And yeah, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you guys. Much love. Peace.